Greetings from Elite English Academy. Welcome to the online GRB coaching for Polytechnic lecturers in English. In this video, we are going to discuss the poem Night of the Scorpion by Nazim Ezekiel. So the person you see on the picture is Nazim Ezekiel, who was based in Mumbai. Now he is no more. And the left side, you have the scorpion, an insect. It is popularly known in our country, which is very poisonous. Even if it stings, people may die. So it is a very beautiful poem in which the writer talks about the Indian. So now let's see something about the author. Nazim Ezekiel is one of the prolific Indian writers in English of the 21st century. He is called as the father of modern Indian English poetry. He is a playwright, editor, critic, and poet. He is a multifaceted person. He is awarded the Sahitya Academy Award for his poetry collection, Later Day Psalms. Also, he was awarded the Padma Shri by the Government of India in 1988. He published this particular poem, Night of the Scorpion, in The Unfinished Man, which was published in 1959. Please note down, this is the important information. This particular poem, Night of the Scorpion, was published in 1959 in Ezekiel's collection of poem, The Unfinished Man. So it is a collection of poems in which it talks about various themes. Though this information is not very important, it is important to understand the background in which he wrote this particular poem. The entire poem revolves around a metaphorical journey of man on this earth, followed by hardships and failures, in which man is subjected to be by the very nature of the earthly life that he leads. So, based on this theme, the poet talks about the suffering of a mother on a particular night because of the scorpion. So, now let's enter into the poem. This is the text, Night of the Scorpion. I remember the night my mother was stung by a scorpion. So, this poem is narrated from first person point of view. You can see the usage of pronoun I. So this poem is narrated in first person point of view, and in which he is describing the incident. The author or the narrator described a night in which his mother was stung by a scorpion. 10 hours of steady rain had driven him to crawl beneath a sack of rice. So, two information is there. 10 hours, how many hours the rain was flowing. So, 10 hours, steady rain, and driven him. Him here refers to the scorpion, not the narrator. Please understand, I refers to the narrator, and here the reference to the pronoun him refers to the scorpion which stung the mother. To crawl back, crawling on the land, crawl back a sack of rice. So after stinging the mother, the scorpion goes beneath the sack of rice and bundle of rice. So it just escaped. Parting with his poison, flash of diabolic tail in the dark room. He risked the rain again. So, parting with poison. So, who parted means separated. So, when an insect bites someone, so the poison will move from its sting to the person who was stung. So, the narrator says, the scorpion parted with his refers to the scorpion. Parted with his poison. Flash of diabolic tail. Diabolic refers to evil. So the tail of the scorpion is compared to evil. So it was a dark room. He risked the rain again. He refers to again the scorpion. So after stinging the mother, for some time it was hiding under the sack of rice, and now again it escaped through the rain. Now we are moving to the third stanza. The peasants came like swarms of flies and buzzed the name of God 100 times to paralyze the evil one. The peasants, the farmers. So when somebody is suffering in a village, the relatives will come. So here is a figure of speech. The peasants came like swarms of flies. So the usage of like and the two comparisons, the peasants are compared to flies, swarms of flies. So it is simile. Simile means open comparison. When two things are compared openly with the words like and as, that is simile. And they just chanted the name of God 100 times to paralyze the evil one. Paralyze, stop. So there is a popular belief by the villagers that when a scorpion moves after stinging a person, so whenever the poison moves, the poison will be moving in the body of the person who is affected. So the villagers, they pray to God that the poison should not move, so that if the poison should not be harmful, the scorpion also should not move. So they are praying like that. This shows their belief in God and how the relatives are showing much concern on the narrator and the family relatives who is being affected. Now we are moving to the next stanza. With candles and with lanterns, throwing giant scorpion shadows on the mud-baked walls, they searched for him. He was not found. So with candles, in those days there was no electricity. So people were using candles and lanterns, kerosene lights. And when the people are standing around the narrator's mother, so the lights, they produced shadows. So for the writer, it looked like the big scorpions. So once the scorpion went away, and now the people are producing scorpion on the wall. It shows that how people are afraid. So once the real scorpion disappeared, but still the people are thinking about the scorpion. And it is reflected on the mud-baked walls. It shows their economic status. Mud-baked walls. So it is, the wall was constructed not by cement, and it was based on mud. So they are relatively poor. They searched for him. Again, the word him refers to the scorpion. He was not found. They clicked their tongues. With every movement that the scorpion made, his poison moved in mother's blood, they said. So as I already mentioned, so the people believe that if the scorpion moves, the poison also will move in the person who is affected. So the people pray to God. So even in that night, during the rainy season, the scorpion should not move. They pray like this. That is given in the next stanza. May he sit still, they said. May the sins of your previous birth be burned away tonight, they said. So may he, again he refers to the scorpion. They prayed to God to make the scorpion sit in one particular place. And in the next line, the people are very optimistic. They are positive. They said, may the sins of your previous birth be burned away tonight. So it is the belief that, so human beings have 7 births. It is the Hindu belief. So one birth sins will be punished in the next birth. Or a person may suffer in this particular birth because of the sins of the previous birth. So the people say positively to the mother, So may the sins of your previous birth. So in the previous birth, you might have committed some sins. So that sin will be burned away tonight because of the suffering you undergo now. May your suffering decrease the misfortunes of your next birth. And also they convey that in the next birth, your suffering will be reduced. So these two ideas convey how positive the village people are. And also we can believe that, so it may be interpreted that it is a superstitious belief. Superstitious belief means a false belief in which people believe something which is not necessary. Again they continue, may the sum of all evil balanced in this unreal world against the sum of good become diminished by your pain. May the poison purify your flesh of desire and your spirit of ambition, they said, and they sat around on the floor with my mother in the center, the peace of understanding on each face. So again the people continue to motivate the mother, you don't worry, you please undergo this pain so that the next birth everything will be equal. So it is like a balance, this unreal world against the sum of good become diminished by your pain. So your pain will decrease all the pains in the next birth. And also they say, may this poison purify your flesh. So human body is filled with so many unwanted things. So they say it is a metaphorical representation. Purify your flesh of desire and your spirit of ambition, they said. And after saying that, they sat around on the floor with my mother in the center, the peace of understanding on each other. So this particular incident shows how the village people show maturity and accept life as it is. So they know once somebody is stung by a poisonous snake or scorpion, that cannot be treated. Only motivation should be given and medical care should be taken. So the people around the mother, they are motivating her and making her believe that you don't worry, everything will be all right. This shows the real concern of the village people. More candles, more lanterns, more neighbors, more insects, and the endless rain. So the poet here describes the situation of that night. So more candles were there, that means more people have come, more lanterns, more neighbors, more insects also come, and the endless pain. Though everyone came there giving the motivational talk and promise, so the rain did not stop. My mother twisted through and through, groaning on a mat. So twisted, she was twisting her arms and legs because of the pain. When the poison moves in her body up to the head, the pain was unbearable, groaning. Groaning then means the noise made by pain. So when we are suffering because of some pain, we are groaning, we are making noise on a mat. So the mother is lying on the mat, people are sitting around her. But there is another character introduced here. My father, skeptic, rationalist, trying every cure and blessing, powder, mixture, herb and hybrid. He did not believe all these things. So the narrator describes, the father is skeptic. He was he did not believe what others believe, rationalist. So he was trying to avoid superstitious beliefs, trying every curse and blessings, powder. So just he did not worry about blessing and cure, but he was trying to give some medicine. Some powder he applied, some mixture of some medicine, herb and hybrid. He gave as many medicines as possible. He even poured a little paraffin upon the bitten toe and put a match to it. So now we are given another information, paraffin. Paraffin, it is a solid substance. So with that, candle is made. So he pours that paraffin on that wound, and he just fired. Here we come to know one information, that the scorpion bit the mother on the toe. That is the important information. I watched the flame, but the narrator watched the flame fire feeding on my mother. Here one poetical device is there. I watched the flame feeding on my mother. Feeding is a human quality. Feeding is a human quality. So which feeding is a human quality, which talks about the poetic device. So that is personification. The fire is attached with the human qualities. I watched the holy man perform his rites to tame the poison with an incantation. Again, another visitor is there. So that is the priest. He comes and he is praying, reciting prayers, and he just tries to do something better. So after 20 hours, another factual information, the pain was for 20 hours, is lost its sting. And finally, after 20 hours, my mother only said, "Thank God, the scorpion picked on me and spared my children." So this shows that the Indianness, how the mother is loving the children. The mother thanked God that, so the scorpion bit me, not my children. This shows the Indianness and love of an Indian mother towards her children. So now the poem is over. So we will review the important information. So points to remember. So how many hours the rain was there? 10 hours. So where does the scorpion hide? Under a sack of rice. And the poet's mother was stung by scorpion in her toe. Toe, it is the big thumb in the leg. And peasants came like swarms. So it is a simile. Simile is used. The poison of the scorpion may burn the skin of previous birth. It is a superstitious belief. And we can call it as religious belief also. So next point is also the same kind. Sufferings may reduce the misfortunes of the next birth. And it is a belief poison may purify the flesh of desire. And the only rationalist being in that family is the father. He uses herb paraffin to control the poison. So how long the effect of the poison is there? 20 hours. And finally, the mother just thanked God. So some important themes found in this particular poem is battle between good and evil, and battle between darkness and light, battle between rationalism and blind faith. And out of this confusion, there arises an unexpected winner, the selfless love of a mother. So who is the ultimate good character who won the heart of the reader is the mother, because she showcased the selfless love of a mother. So now the poem is over. Dear learners, so this is how all video lessons will be there. If it is a poetry, so the poem text will be explained. The important factual information and poetic devices will be pointed out. Then some important review would be there. So if you follow our lectures closely, definitely you can answer any question that is to be asked in the exam. So please share this information among your friends. If you also wish to join, please contact Elite English Academy, Madurai. Thank you. All the best.